From the studios of Books in Motion, this is Andrea Bates, reading the third Samantha Sweet mystery, Sweet Holidays, by Connie Shelton. Now let's begin with Chapter 1. Samantha Sweet tucked a sprig of sugar holly against the Yule log cake she'd just created, her final one for the day. She tapped a sprinkling of powdered sugar over the chocolate-rolled confection and called out to the front room.
"Jennifer, this is ready for the display case."
Her petite assistant walked into the kitchen, dusting cookie crumbs from her purple apron with the Sweet Sweet logo embroidered on it. The shop slogan, "A Bakery of Magical Delights," seemed especially appropriate this time of year. Sam always marveled at how Jen's makeup and dark hair in its neat chignon seemed nearly as fresh in the late afternoon as first thing in the morning. "It's snowing out there," Jen commented, sending a smile toward the holiday pastry as she lifted it from Sam's work table. "Think it'll stick?" Jen shrugged. "Hard to say. Probably not." Sam washed her hands at the sink and followed Jen out to the sales area, pleased to see that the usual late afternoon customers had not let her down, despite the looming weather front. The first week of December was a little early for lasting snow, but the mountains of northern New Mexico could expect just about any weather this time of year. She walked over to the front window of her shop and peered out into the deepening dusk. White pellets blew horizontally across the parking lot, gathering in small drifts against the curb.
"I can close up early if you want to leave," Sam told Jen. "I have to take a quick inventory and order more supplies anyway. That order for the county employee's Christmas party wiped out a few of our necessities."
The younger woman looked up from the bistro tables where she'd been giving everything a quick swipe. She tucked a single strand of dark hair behind her ear and rinsed out her cleaning rag.
"You sure? It's been a busy day for you, too."
"Luckily," Sam turned from the window. "I thought we'd have a big slowdown after all the Thanksgiving pies were gone, but it just hasn't happened. It's like everyone's on a sugar binge." Jen wiggled her eyebrows.
"And you're loving it."
Sam felt her smile widen.
"You bet. I know we've talked about this before. A few customers have asked about candies. You know, chocolates, truffles, stuff like that."
Sam bit her lip. She'd definitely considered adding candy to the normal bakery offerings, but other than the cocoa she used in flavoring her frostings and decorations, she didn't have much experience with chocolate. Only enough to know that it could really get tricky if it weren't tempered and handled correctly.
"I need to think about it, Jen. I can't afford to risk the reputation of the shop by putting out anything that isn't top quality, and I sure don't have the time this season to take classes and learn how to do it. Maybe later."
"Sure. Just passing along customer requests."
"I know. Thanks."
Sam smiled as she glanced out the window again.
"Go on now. And be careful. The visibility sucks."
Jen pulled off her apron and hung it on one of the hooks inside the work area. Sam locked the front door behind her, turned over the closed sign, and dimmed the lights to their nighttime settings. Pulling the cash from the register, she carried it to the small desk she'd set up for herself in the back room and began counting. But her mind zipped in 100 directions, and she found herself going back for a third count before she gave up and pulled out her calculator. She liked the idea of adding candy to her offerings. Plus, they'd had several requests for Jewish holiday treats as well. Hanukkah would begin only 4 days before Christmas this year, so she really needed to address both holidays at once. Taos didn't have many Jews, so Sam was only now learning about those traditional foods, let alone how to make them. Luckily, she thought, her friend Zoe might have some of the recipes, and Sam planned on begging for help from that quarter. And she'd already gotten orders for 2 Christmas-themed weddings and another on New Year's Eve. Cakes, table favors, and even some rather randy bachelorette treats. Then there was her other job. Sam broke into houses, legally, for the U.S. Department of Agriculture.
her main source of steady income before the bakery came into being. Now that finances were more stable and she had a little nest egg, she could easily afford to quit that one. But there was the little matter of her government contract. Her supervising officer, Delbert Crow, didn't seem inclined to simply let her out of it. For the moment, she'd had a short breather. Lawns and shrubs took the winter off, thank goodness, leaving Sam with only two properties where she had to stop in for a few minutes a week, just to be sure no pipes had frozen or roofs had leaked. So far, so good on that count. Her cell phone startled her out of that train of thought. She pulled it from her pocket of her slacks. "Mom!" Kelly's voice had a note of urgency. "Yeah, hon? I need a ride home. I'm at Romero's garage. Problem with your car?" "Kind of." Kelly stalled in the same way Sam remembered from her daughter's teen years. "Well, it's got a bent wheel rim." Sam bit the inside of her cheek, forcing herself not to ask. Okay. I went off the road." Kelly's years of living in Southern California hadn't exactly prepared her for winters back here in the mountains. "I'm just leaving the bakery. I should be there in about 10 or 15 minutes. Normally, a trip to the garage that had serviced her vehicles for years would take 5, but tonight she had a feeling the streets were getting messy. She stuffed her bank deposit into a zippered bag, gathered her coat and backpack, and rechecked the doors and lights before walking out into the alley behind the bakery. Her delivery van, with its elaborate design that looked like an overflowing box of baked treats, now sported a light powdered sugar coating and a skiff of white coated the ground. She scuffed the toe of her sneaker across the pavement to test the slickness of it. Not that bad. Kelly had probably just panicked. Unless she was texting. Sam sighed and muttered all the choice words she wanted to say to her daughter, but probably wouldn't. There's only so much lecturing a mom can do after a kid hits 30. She unlocked the van and tossed her backpack inside, her thoughts darting from her daughter's predicament to the supply order she'd not had time to place, to the ever-nagging question of what she could make for a quick dinner. She'd only begun to edge one hip toward the driver's seat when a man stepped out of the shadows. Sam's heart thudded.
"Madam of the sweet shop? Please, do not leave."
His accent was European, something with hints of French or German, but not quite sure. She let the van's door stay between herself and the large man who walked slowly toward her. His clothing was rough, a heavy wool coat of dark brown or black, dusted with snowflakes, dark pants, thick boots, a soft wool hat. The 6-foot frame and heavy facial features belied the delicate hands that reached toward her, palms up. Sam started to make an excuse for not digging into her wallet for some cash, but he interrupted.
"Please, madam, I am here to helping you."
"Look, I'm really..." He removed the hat, revealing dark hair that fluffed away from his scalp in thin wisps.
"I'm Gustav Bobul."
"And I'm supposed to know you?"
"Chocolatier extraordinaire."
She felt her eyebrows draw together in puzzlement.
"I create such lovely confections. The exquisite tastes to one's delightful vision and one's palate. You need me."
Had Jen set this up?
"Well, I'm not really looking to hire anyone right now. The holidays, we're very busy."
"I know this. Is no need to pay. I come to answer a great need for you."
How did he know? "I'm really in a hurry right now, Mr.
Bobul. You simply call me Bobul."
"Yeah, well, I have to..."
"I understanding. I come back tomorrow."
He did a little flourish with the hat, plopped it back on his head, and walked up the alley. In under 10 seconds, he had disappeared into the storm. Sam stared at the end of the alley, where sleet raced through the cone of light from a street lamp.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.